सौरभ कैन यू हियर मी?
यस यस आई कैन हियर यू।
ओके थैंक यू। I request to all of you, please mute yourself. Please turn off your video. Request to all, please turn off your video and please mute yourself. Our speaker joined. Purbo sir, can you hear me?
Yes, you are
Thank
audible.
you. We are on live. Good evening to everyone.
Should I start?
Please wait. Very good evening to everyone. I welcome you all to this discussion session on Koha report module. Today's session will be delivered by Dr. Apurva Jyoti Majumdar, Assistant Librarian of Assam University. He is a very active library professional and well-known Koha expert. Now I request to Apurva sir, please deliver lecture on Koha report module. Sir, please start.
Hello. Good afternoon to all. This is not actually a lecture. This is all about a discussion about how we work in Koha report module. I would like to hear from you and what your expectation from Koha and basically the report module. Whenever any of your library automation software, the basic work is doing your library housekeeping operations or whatever your library activity. But the end of the at the end of the session, about wherever you require, you have to generate the reports. Am I audible to you all?
Yes, sir. You are pretty well. Yes. Some music coming from your phone, I think.
Maybe the fan is on. That's why.
System.
Someone is saying, please minimize the window. That's already minimized.
Okay. Continue, sir.
So, first, I will discuss a bit about the report module. Let's go to the portal. This is my own library. This is the Assam University Central Library. I'm maintaining this server with the help of L2C2 Technologies. They are our technology partner and other my colleagues. So the thing is that as and when the university asks for report, we have to provide the report regarding library and its activities. So in like all library automation software, I have used mostly Sol, then transferred to Koha. The report module is very much important. Like the question that is asked regularly, that is called what is the collection of your size? What is the collection of different subjects? What are the number of issues and returns? What are the fines collected? How many library clearance I have given? What is the collection size as on date? Some lost books, some other different, some released patrons, what are the students, number of students, number of scholars. These are come the official statements I have to provide. Then comes the what is called questionnaire of different research scholars coming to us at different time. We have to provide them the data, required data also. So required data also. The thing is, just hold on. I am sharing a screen. So this way, these are the reports we have to provide. Being an open source software, most of the software will provide you a module for report. And the thing is that in those software, there is a proprietary software. The reports are mainly what is called predefined. The setups are predefined. I'm checking if anybody in the chat, if there is any question. I'll just the same thing, I'll just check the questions. So the report is the main, most of the open proprietary software, the reports are predefined. But in case of Koha or on other open source software, we design the reports according to our need. Remember, most of the software, or you can say in case of a library software, they are using in the background the SQL. And the, in the report for all the data, whatever we are doing here, that is saved in the form of SQL tables or SQL commands. So whenever we are trying to derive the report, so we are fetching the data. We are fetching the data from the SQL tables of my database. So like this is my Koha portal. If you are a super user, you can have this report module. I'm just going to click here report one. Then I will show what are the different kind of reports you can generate. These are the, this is the first page in the 19.11. This is the Koha 19.11. So either you can create a report or you can use the predefined report that we have already created, or you can copy it from the report library, Koha report library. So Koha, different users of Koha, as is a open source software, this is a collaborative word. If I click on Koha report library, you'll find the browser will take me to an SQL report library where different reports are already in there. Documents like these are catalog without withdraw, and category wise, catalog and bibliography report. These are the different report, count on all item, count on all item, total collection size. So if you copy and paste these reports, you do not have to design the report by yourself. These are already designed by users, expert, and already tested. So you can have assure yourself that whatever report you are generating, that is 100% correct. So the simple policy, and you search for the exact report that you want from him to be generated and search it. So this is what called Koha report library. You can copy and paste from. So first we will go how many type of report you can generate. I'm click on Koha report. Like category wise report you can generate. For accounts, accounts means this is for your, what is the monetary transaction, fines, loss book cost, then your any type of other collection you have collected. What type of monetary expenditure through your database. So you can collect it from here. Acquisitions. So this report will collect to your collection. Vendor wise, how much you were collected. So accession registered, lost items, orders, ledger. These things you can generate from here. That means, whenever you will be generating, the subcategory will be acquisition. Someone has kept their mic on. Someone has kept their mic on. Let me check. All the participants are requested to keep their mic on mute position. Otherwise, it will create an...
Yes.
So these are the different categories: accounts, acquisition, then most important catalogs.
Sir,
like a different.
Sorry, sir. Yeah. Yes. Some system on your end. Some system, huh? Some.
No. Some system sound means whenever somebody is joining, the sound comes. That's the Cisco sound. That's all. Nothing else.
Okay. Okay. So,
these are the. Then, these are the acquisitions catalog. Different catalog. You have to just assume what type of question you may be asked by the authority, or by the user, or by the researcher, and in the same time, to verify your database, you have to generate some reports to verify your database, whether my database is 100% correct or not, whether there is any error. There may be some books or some biblio data you have entered that finally you have not entered any item for that. Sometimes you have already entered a book after 2 months. That is most what I am talking about. That is mostly done during retrospective conversion. During retrospective conversion, we are taking the books from the stacks and going for the data entry. In that case, what happens? We are getting the same books at a different time, and we are entering the data without checking the what is called already availability in the database. So in that case, what happens? The same bibliographic record comes in a different bibliography. Same bibliographic record comes in two different biblio. That is, suppose library manager, you have got library manager by S.R. Ranganathan, you have purchased the body book of 5 copies. 3 copies you have entered today, and other 2 copies you were entered after 2 months. So in both the times, the books are same. As per rule, what we say, what is the rule? All these 5 copies should come under single biblio. But as our two different catalogers entered the time at the two different time, so what they did, 3 books together, later 2 books together. So what happened? The same book comes under 2 biblio. So it will unnecessarily show that my record number is high. Unnecessarily showing my record number. In that case, you have to check. How will check? You will check with the report module. Then there may be some books, there is no item. There may be some null. There is books, there is no barcode. So lots of things you can check with the report. Then it comes the circulation reports, like top 10 books. What are the nodules you have given? That is, what are the overdues? Like financial, you can collect. Total circulation count, how many books issued, return. These are the data we have to provide during the annual report. Then patrons, staff report, patrons data. In my library, what we are doing, we are basically the central data warehouse for the users. So we are the library identity card and the university identity card same. And the library issues the identity card. That is a print bar, that is plastic card with a barcoded, plastic barcoded library card that is used simultaneously as an iCard. So we are keeping all the data from their name to their blood group. We are keeping all the data in our server. That is the Koha server. As and when there is a requirement, any type of data, we have to provide the data in a tabular form and whatever form the user wants. User means my authority. The IQSE, the register, or the sometime my health center asks for the blood group. It happens that sometime some blood group blood is required, blood donation. That they ask me, sir, just provide the details of the patrons who have the same blood group. So you have to provide this type. We have to create the reports. Then serials, that is mostly not used by any libraries as of date. So that is the serial controls is the less touched section of a library automation software. Mostly the serials are maintained manually, but we are also trying to update our full serial in our Poha database. So we are also trying to maintain the serial section. It's a complicated, because regarding books and serials, there is a complete different setup. In books, what happens? You give an order, you got the books, checked it, paid. Your work is done. After this, pull your technical work. In terms of serials, each and every serial is a different item, a different entity, different biblio, you can say. So I am giving order to around 100 publishers. In my library, we are giving order to 100 publishers. We are getting the journals at different time of the year, because all the journals have their different frequency. We have to keep record on each and everything, each and every issue, because at the as we have paid them 100% amount in advance. This is the basic difference between book purchase and journal subscription. In book purchase, it is postpaid. In journal subscription, it is prepaid. And 100% payment of the subscription of next year should be paid in advance. So there is always a risk of audit objection. Objection in the form, where are the issues? If you got 100% issues, if you receive 100% issues, no problem. You can keep the record, you just provide the report to the finance section. They are happy. If any issue is missing, suppose you have subscribed a journal, that should be 6 issues per year. One issue is missing. Two options. Either you have to collect the missing issue from the publisher, or you pay adjust the amount. Adjust amount is also a two options. Either you have to ask for refund, or in next year, if you are subscribing the same item next year, you can deduct the money. So these are the two. So forget about that. So serial. So these are the different sections. So the different section. So now we will create a report. Before going to create a report, you should have an idea of the tables, that is the SQL tables, and for which data, which table, which particular field is required. So that will be that you can have a brief idea during how we will create a report. Like you can see different records we have already created. You just run a report, we'll see. So let's test the report first. Whatever report we have, let's test the report. Let's test the catalog report. So I will test how many collection. What is my collection size department wise? The report is already created. So I'll just click on run. The report will be visible here. So here, if any department, like I have 41 department, and all the department have their departmental libraries. The purchase policy is central library purchases the books for the department. And if they want, they can transfer the book to the departmental library for easy access. Because in our geographical location, my university is set on a like here, not a hill, but is a uneven geographical terrain. You can say it's a small hilltop. So, and at the top of the hill, there is a library. So, from the last department, it comes around 1 kilometer. On the terrain to come to my library. So it is not possible for each and every user when they cannot come to library just randomly and go back. it's a tough job. So what we did, there is a concept of departmental library. Some of the books are in the central library, some of the books in the departmental library. The database is common. Some of the departments maintain the issue written on the department level. So we are maintaining the record here. See, if I want to see how many books are there in the business administration, that is the MBA department. I'll click on run the report. It will tell me that there are total number of results. There is 881. Sorry, 811. That is number of books in management departmental libraries, 811. And these are the barcodes, means accession numbers. These are the, this is the title, author, and this is the collection code. That is, it is an internal code. So if management department asks me, IDG has joined. If management department asks me, Purva, what is our collection size? We have to show to our in our records. So immediately, I have to provide them. In manual system, if you are keeping separate accession register, then only it is possible. You are keeping the records intentionally. Intentionally, you are keeping the records in manual system. Searching or files, you can provide the report. But in terms of, in my database, I have kept only, I have given a collection code. Whenever a books are purchased for the Department of Management, whenever I am entering the data, I am putting the collection code so that whenever, as and when it is asked by the management department, I can provide them the exact data. So this is how I can provide them. And the most important thing, if they want me the, if they want the full list, I can download it for here. Commerce separator text, that is a CSV. You can, it will be opened in you can it will be opened in the, what is called your Excel. Tab separator, it can it will be opened in your any other software, like a tab separator. You can copy the text in Word and then convert it to tabular form. And you can, if I click it open document spreadsheet, it will be opened here. So I can download the full list. And this is only an option, like a barcode. Yeah,
Tab separated will also open in Excel and open office or LibreOffice.
Yes, yes. Tab separated is simply like that. If you want to, like comma separated is the table, that is the field, that is field, that is the cells are different by comma. If it is separated by tab, you can download in any software and just then you convert it in the tabular form. So here you will see only four columns. You can make it up to 10 column according to your requirement. This is simply during the formation, that is the design of this report, you just add this particular column from the, and all these records are taken from Biblio. That is a Biblio table, barcode, title, author, and collection code. So this is just, I have shown you one sample record, sample report. So these are, in case of saved report, as a university library, I have created around, how many, let me check, around 98 report, different report design we have already created and saved it. So that as and when required, we can immediately click and generate the report. Like here you can see collection details. If I click on collection details, I'll click on run. It will show me departmental collection. These are my collection. These are my collection, what is called code. If anybody asks me, what is your collection? Different type of books, type of item. DC is department collection, gifted book, general books, that is the textbooks, journal, map, that is basic collection, reference and thesis. So this is a one, like here I can see six items. There is no item type has been defined. So I have to, I can search it later and edit it accordingly. So any type, anybody asking what is your collection size, like research scholar asking, sir, provide us your full collection details, bifurcated at the collection site. So this is how I generate the, that is generate the report. This is fully that is in-house. It's not like that all the reports I have designed myself. Most of the reports are already that is already available in the Koha report library. We just take we just copy and paste the coding from here, and rest of the things are done. Sometimes we generate the report that is the design the report ourselves. So now we'll just we'll go to how to create a report from Koha step by step. So before going to that, I'd like to have some query from my respected participants. I have to query some queries from respected participants. Let's see if anybody has any query regarding report. Then we'll go for a generate a report from Koha itself. Then one from copy and paste from your Koha report library. Both we'll discuss here. Any query from anybody? At this moment, we have 50 participants. So like this is not a lecture series. This is not a webinar also. This is all about discussion. Unless and until whenever I am going to any type of discussion like this, like IDG, this is Indranil Dasgupta sir has also joined us. There are some other senior Koha users also in that in our group now. So unless and until there is a discussion, something fruitful doesn't ever come. There is a question, sir. Is it available in Windows OS? If I frankly speak, is no. Like and remember, whenever you are asking questions, concentrate on the topic we are discussing. We are here discussing on the Koha report module. If you have any question on the report module, most of you are maybe using the report module, you are comfortable. Maybe you are not using the report module. So if you have any query on the report module, it will be easier for us to discuss. Otherwise, I will just keep on showing my steps. You will just see, and the things will be like other webinars. It's nothing to say sorry, Mr. BBA Aisha. It's nothing to Mr. Miss sorry. It's you have asked the question. We have given the answer. It's not nothing like that. But try to concentrate on the report module. Like if you want anything, like some whenever there is a discussion, there must be some doubts, because reports, these are the least used module of Koha. Like Jithin is saying, it's over MariaDB. Importance of ManaDB in report. What is ManaDB? Like if I would talk about database, whatever we are doing, whatever we are saving, Mana Central database, whatever. So it's all about wherever we are saving in the database is going in the form of SQL tables. Again, somebody is asking for feedback link. What is the use of this feedback link? Whenever I am attending any Koha, any type of webinar, the participants are asking for feedback link. Remember, feedbacks are only required by the host. BB Aisha, the demerits of report module. No module has any demerit. No module has any demerit. Only the merits are added in your software.
There is one demerit.
Yeah, please.
The one demerit is that you need to be at least able to copy paste.
No, that is not a demerit actually. Somebody is saying, don't ask for this feedback link. We are not going to provide you any type of e-certificate. Whatever feedback you find it good, you can find it bad, you can put up here. This is a simple discussion, like we are chatting somewhere in the WhatsApp and in the Facebook. It's a simple discussion. We are trying to share our knowledge with them, our experience. Someone is trying to say anything?
No, no, sir. I think. If you have any queries, please comment in chat box.
So now, okay, now we'll show you how to generate a report. How to generate means first how to design a report. How to design a report. I'll again go to reports. Yeah, somebody is saying Ruby Acharya. If I want to return some books from departmental library, can it show? Ms. Acharya, I'm not getting your question actually. If I want to return some.
Good evening. Good evening, Junior sir, also. Good evening, everybody. I just want to ask something. If I added some books in central library and I want to send it to departmental library, is it possible in Koha?
Yes, it is possible in Koha. There's a transfer option. You can transfer or directly you can change the location to departmental library.
As well as when I want to return that book from departmental library, as I need that book in central library also, if that option is possible, then is it shown in our report section also?
No. Reports are basically shows at least the current position. Some books you have transferred to departmental library and again it's coming to central library. Actually, what is the intention, what is the motive of creating a report then? If it can be generated, if I transfer the books in the circulation to the departmental library.
Apurva.
If the departmental library itself acts as a user and they have given the books and after 7 days they...
I did sir something on this.
The question that Ruby asked. Ruby, are you listening?
Listening, sir.
Yeah, the question that Ruby asks is something that she faces in her organization quite frequently, or one of her sister organizations. What they do is, at the time of inspection and other things, are suddenly books have to be shifted from one departmental library, brought over to central library, and then again it's kind of like an interim stock transfer for display purpose. Isn't that what you were referring to, really?
Yeah, definitely, sir.
So what is the actual question?
My question is, if I want to transfer some books from one place to another, maybe that is from one department to another department or central library to departmental library, there may be some basic rules or record. After that, when I am transferring that books or that record, I need to come back or that books in my central library. Is there any report section that which book and how many books I have transferred from one department to another or one library to another? Is there any possibility to give any record of that, of transferring any books?
Transferring any books from the report module.
Indunilda, regarding I can share my experience.
Please,
there are two options. Forget about report. If you want this type of report, like in my case, what happens? My departments are here designed as a departmental library. That is a branch library. And whenever I am transferring, we are basically changing the location in the database. And it goes to the department. We are maintaining the record manually in our files. And mostly it never comes back to us. In your case, what happens? Your case is temporary transfer and incoming. In that case, this best option is you make the departments as patrons and issue the books in the to the department library. And whenever they are coming back, you can simply keep, you just click as a record of this transfer, and that is circulation record of the department, and instantly it will come. That will basically solve your purpose.
Sorry to interrupt. That inspectors who are come, they are not, they want to show your departmental library. Is it clear?
Okay.
Yeah, they if you issue some books to patron from central library, they have no departmental library. You have an
okay,
record.
Okay. So in your case, it is the departmental library, and they have to show you the departmental library status.
Yeah, and you have to give books from departmental library also, and there should be some records from departmental library. You have to give that book from to some members.
Okay.
Yeah. But
so
whenever they get it over, you have to return that all of those books in your library.
Okay.
As those books are important to you. Is there any record from? I have just one question.
No. This record is fetchable, but not from. I think not from report section. It's from the log section. IDG. Is there any report whether I can transfer? Because there is an option of transfer. We use.
No. See. I know exactly the thing that Ruby is referring to in her particular use. What they want to do is when they do the transfer, they basically it's like a digital equivalent of a gate pass. So they have to generate a digital equivalent of a gate pass. The report will be a kind of a digital equivalent of gate pass that these books are being shifted out of the departmental library, and now will be shown temporarily during the inspection as part of the central library. But after the inspection is over, or after whatever compliance visit is over, then again those same books have to be shifted back to the departmental library. This is the circus that they have to entertain. So that is the
practical issues.
I know. So
not happened in their library. They will
right. Be, yes. So yes, one thing you can do, Ruby, I don't know, but we are going slightly off track here. I don't know how many of you are aware of something called a batch issue, batch checkout. So Koha has this option called batch checkout. So instead of checking out one book at a time, you can do a complete batch checkout. So what you can do, what you can do, as I'm taking apart from what Apurva is saying, that what you do is you create a special user or a special patron, which you name as whichever library you want to transfer to. This is just a statistical account, not a real person account. Now, once into that account, all the books that you need to transfer, so those books, you can get that book list as a department list, or you can pick and choose the books. You do a batch checkout to that account. Now, after you do the batch checkout, you can check all those books back in. So the books are again back to your departmental library. It's kind of a two-step tango. So first, you check do a batch checkout to that statistical user. Then you do a check-in. The moment you do this, then the statistical reports from the report module will be able to show the total list.
I interrupt. Actually, for her case, what I think, she also want to show batch checkout is going to a particular user, particular patron basically. So that I said, but she, her case, what I understand, she, for her case, there should be a departmental, that is departmental library in the like sub library, and they want to issue return from that library also in front of this that is inspection maybe. So the batch checkout will not be help. There is a transfer option. In my library, I have initially started the transfer option. It goes to departmental library transfer, and I have never tried to generate any record of the transfer. But the transfer option is possible, that initially we transfer the book to the central library. To departmental library shows this library to library transfer, not library to user. So that module will help you definitely. So as we have got a query, we'll try to generate a report for the transfer, not maybe today, because today we have never got this type of problem. So I'll definitely try to generate a report of transfer. Like it will go to library, again come back to library, central library to library A. Again, after 6 months, it came back from library A to central library. So both the libraries, it will be visible. Whenever your inspection is coming, your central departmental library, you can issue it from departmental library. Again, it will, after 6 months, it will come to central library. So for that, transfer option will be best for you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you to all of you.
So next query is Saurabh Devnath. Is it possible to generate file collection user category, PG faculty year wise? Yes, this is possible. You can generate a file collection year wise. The thing is that provided you have entered this data during patron data entry. Year means, do you enter the data of year? What does year means here? Saurabh Devnath. Category is understood. You are entering that category. UG, PG, PhD and faculty. What is your year? Where you put this data during that patron data entry? Saurabh Devnath. Are you listening?
Year means like in 2017, maybe some of the total fine collection will be shown, but sometimes the administration is asking about give us the details like for the UG.
That is fine. Your question is fine. Is it,
you have taken.
Your question is fine. Is it Saurabh Devnath speaking?
Yes, sir. Yes.
The thing is that 2017, 2018, 2019, in terms of user, where do you put this data? Like if you want to make it 2017 means the basically date will be given, the date will be visible to you. Whenever you are, I'm showing you Saurabh Devnath, I am showing you my report, how you generate the report for this fines collected. Then I'll show how the records. Then I click on accounts. So total fine paid in a date range. So what are the outputs? From outputs, you can filter basically 2017, 18, 19, and you can filter according to category. I'll check like your 2019 you want. I will give the data here between 2019 0 4 0 1 2020 03 31. Okay, so this is the data I've given. 2019 is basically the one for the financial year. If I click on the report, it will give me the output. There is an error in my report. So it's not giving the account type. So I'll go for another report. Accounts, fines, write-off, patron fee, fine payment details. I click on this. Run. These are the records. Here the faculty members. Here are the faculty members, like a T category code is given, and I can add the date here also, and you can simply filter from the list, and you can generate, no issues.
Okay, sir, I got it. I was asking about whether that filtering option, without filtering option from the report, we can generate or not. Thank you, sir. I got it.
You can generate, no problem. You can generate from here also without filtering. Next question is No more question as of now. Is it possible to send any message to our user? Vikas Kumar Haldar, this is also not related to this module. You can send a messages to your users. That will be possible whenever they are logged in. So now we will design a report. We'll click on new report. There are two types, new SQL report. Means I will just copy paste from the report library. New guided, either I will type it myself or I will copy paste. And new guided report means I will prepare a report step by step. These are the what circulation, what type of report I want, circulation, catalog, patron, acquisition, account, serial. So I will prepare a, okay, let's prepare a circulation report. It's not public, catch expiry, seconds. That is after, if the report is not generated in 300 seconds, it will be drop the trying to generate the report. Next, you will see it is the tabular form. I'll click on next. Next, you have to pick the fields which you want to fetch. Like I want to fetch the card number, add. Their surname, forename is not required. These are the data I feed. All these fields. Then their expiry date, no, the lost card, restricted. I want their category. I'll just their category. Basically, in my library, from the number, I can see that I can tell the category, but still, I want to have their category. Alternative circulation node, relationship, gender, passwords, opaque node, alternative, borrowers, address, privacy, last seen login attempts, statistics, library branch, like item number, item barcode, add. Collection code not required. So these two things I want to add. Two tables will come. Let's check whether I can generate any report from here or not. These are the things, Koha item type. I will just item type as gen. Patron category. All patron category will be taken. Library, I'll click it, main library, here main, next. Borrower's card number, that is click it column, so total is not required. Let's see whether I can generate any report from what I have done. I don't know what I have done, what is my intentions. Still, I have selected two things. Save. Regarding save, I have to give a name. I'll give here a test report group. I'll give in circulation. Notes, I have not given a note. Save report. I'll run it. Let's see whether it gives any output or not. I'll run the report. Category code. I'll give as faculty. I'll click run the. Let's see whether it gives any report or not. So these are the reports it's generating. These are the books this particular user has issued at some time. Next, we'll create another report. From catalog. Or from patrons. So if I want the email ID. Email ID of a particular patron. Okay, I will click on next. So what are the record I need? I need the card number, add surname, add post name, add, and their email IDs, primary email and primary phone. These are the record I want. Next. Now these are the columns will be displayed. Now we'll see from which. So from main library, that is central library and patron category, faculty member. I want the email ID of the faculty members and their phone number to be displayed. Columns, no column, not to be total. And order, how will it order? It will order with borrowers. You can take borrowers first name, take it borrower first name. It will be sorting, that is the alphabetical sorting. Save it. Before running, after creation, all the reports you have to save it. Then again, I will give a name, test one. Test one. I'll secure here patron because it's under patron category. Even if you don't put a report group, it will be accepted. We'll keep on save report. Now we'll run it. I'll run. It possibly give me the report of the email. Card number, surnames. Like for, because it's running in the which first name, it's what is called sorted. So that's why coming, I've changed this 100. Let's give here all my users surnames and their email ID is coming. So one mistake I have done, I have not selected the option during the faculty members. I should have selected the option from borrowers. I have selected the option, so I'll delete this. So I want the only the report of the faculty members. This report will again go for it. New report. I'll click on patron. Next. Patron. Next. Now we'll again some less data, so it comes immediately. Borrower card number. Add their first name, add surname, add their primary email, add primary phone, add next. Now we'll filter it according to, and this filter option you can keep. The report generation also, if I keep it like that, it will be taken during report generation. If I click the section, the particular category will come here. What will happen? It will come, I will select the particular category during report generation. I'll save it. It name test one under patron, save report, and then I'll put on run. What you will show, it will ask for the patron category. Hopefully, yeah, it's asking for patron category because patron category I have click the button, but I have not selected any patron category there. I'll click on faculty, run the report. It will give me the list of the faculty members with their email ID and phone number. So whenever I have to provide the data of the faculty member and their email ID and phone number. I can date it. If anything wrong record, like showing assistant professor, I have to edit it in my record. So this is how I can generate and I can download it. Now it's showing 329. I can, if I put it 400 here, initially it takes 220. You can change the number and you can download from here. Like, see, these are the card numbers of the faculty members. These are their names, surnames, their email IDs. Some email IDs are blank. So it should be updated in my database. So these are the record. I can instantly, I can generate and provide it to my administration. This is when it is required. Sometimes implementer asks for this record. Sometimes we have to activate some services to my faculty members. Each and every time I cannot ask my faculty member provide your data. Once they have provided their data, it's final. We'll keep it. And whenever it is required, we'll use that. So I think report generation, one simple sample report design I have shown you. Now let's see. If I can have any question. Any query?
Do you have any questions?
I have a query.
Yes, sir.
Apurva, can you show what happens if you if the base URL system preference is not not set up and you try to execute a report? I think you should show that.
Again, I have to go to system preferences.
Yes.
Administration
base URL, there will be two, one for OPAC, one for staff client. Go for the staff client. Not that one, not that one.
This one,
yeah.
The staff client is located as. Here it is located.
Yeah, by default this is usually blank.
It's coming in library opaque.aus.ac.in.
Just remove that and see what happens to your report. Temporarily just remove it, save it, go to your report module and see what happens.
Reports. Let's see.
You served.
Try the test. We have tested something. Patron.
Just click on any of the just click on any of the JSON links.
JSON links are not.
Just click on it.
Nowadays,
click on it.
There's nothing.
Nothing, right? Now go back, add the staff client to your base URL, then come back and click it.
But here I have a doubt in your base URL. The base URL shows the port number here.
Yeah.
But in my base URL, the port number is already included.
Just change this. Just change it to the 14.137. Don't use that.
Okay.
It will be HTTP:// /14.137.2. Ah, 171:8000.
Earlier 8000 was not required. If I put
just do it. Never mind. Now go back to report module. Just click on any of those JSON links from saved. This is not giving any. Try another. Try a different report. Just say one of the reports that you just created.
Oh, wait, that's I'm going for that only.
Oh, you have to give a parameter. No, don't use anything with a parameter. Don't use a report with anything that calls for a parameter.
Okay, direct report.
Hmm.
I'm taking any direct report. Lost item. I think it will ask for parameter like this. This is coming.
So this is a JSON output. Okay.
Okay.
Now, if you count it, you will find only 10 results.
Okay.
Like from the square bracket to square bracket, if you count, there is the first one, then the second one. There'll be 10 reports. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
If you actually physically count the beginning square brackets, for each of the title, you'll find 10.
Okay.
You counted it, right?
Okay, 10.
10, right. Now go back to the system preferences. System preferences, and then search for SVC. 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 Yeah, search. Right. Now,
10.
Yeah. 10. Make it 100. Save it. Run the JSON output again. Okay, it's going by a hard coding.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's being hard coded. Okay.
So actually, what happens if now it's showing 14.139.217? Even if I am using I am not using the local server. Even right. If I am accessing from inside, it will be showing the perfect record.
Yeah, it will.
Okay.
That IP translation will be done by your firewall device.
Okay. So now next we'll go for prepare a new SQL report. We'll just copy paste one report from OHA SQL library and try to test that. Total collection size by date. We'll copy it. Test 3. We'll acquisition, we'll paste it. Sorry, the wrong place. Paste it here. Save report. Let's see what it gives. I'll run it. So simply, I have copied a that is prepared by someone else. I already saved. These are the because these open source software. All these things are shared by all the users. Like it show total number of collection. That is and subcategory wise. There is the home branch. There is the departmental library. Like as Ruby was asking, this is the showing the departmental library and particular category. In departmental library, department collection means they have purchased their own 195 books. ETD means electronics and telecommunication. And here general means the books has been taken from your central library, transfer from central library. Here no category has been used. Here I will click it. This is showing from Grammarly. So this is how I can design a report that is already been tested and already been the SQL. There is coding has been shared. If some report I have generated myself, so I can also share it in the SQL report library. But most of the reports are already given there by experts, so category wise. And this report also helps you to that is filter your database. Sometimes what we do, our data entry is done by our technical stuff, still there are some mistakes as from officer point of view or the supervisor point of view. We test the reports different times, like in case of catalog, like report, how many titles has by a particular cataloger. So I will first test what is my number. Let me check what is my number here. This Purbo Jyoti Majumdar, here that is details. Here my card number will not be working. This borrower's number will be working. So it's 34. Now I will try to make a report how many cataloging I have done for a period, like whenever the data entry is done by the your data entry operator, you can do it. How many catalog titles hidden by cataloger. If I put on run, let's see what report it gives. Borrower number I give 34. So whenever you are going to pay for your data entry operator, you can test it from here. You can generate the report. 182 titles till date I have cataloged. Till date I have cataloged 182 catalog directly using my own account. So this is how we'll who can use for I missed one thing. We are also organizing one training for serials control. If you want to attend that program, it's on 10th and 11th August. The training will be imparted by Mr. Amit Urao, assistant librarian, Assam University. He is the in charge of serial control section. You will be always technically backed up by Indra Nilinda, and I'll be there. So if you want to attend this program, just visit our blog, that is necolib.blogspot.com. This is our blog. You can see the program details and you can attend. This is a paid program. You can attend that program, and for that program will have training, then test, then we'll provide you the certificate. Any more questions?
Sir, two option: create chat and fetch all data for chart. Create chart and fetch all data for chart. Two new option is here. I think it is new version.
This
So
is the new version. Yes, chat. We are now, for 2 days. I am just trying to show the general how to design the reports. Not going to very much advanced steps, because those advanced steps are basically not even tested by me too. Like create chart 19.11, and recently I have started using. But whenever in a single program, that
just
is
for
likely.
two options.
Okay, I'll click on this create chart and pie chart. Like title said it. I click on draw. No chart will be here because there is a single line. For this, I need a I have to show a report first. I have to take a different report first.
Yes.
Okay, I take a different report. Whether there's a multiple patron list by category.
Patron.
My collection size will be helpful better. Catalog.
Thanks.
Will probably help to create the chart. I'll create sorry, now here is the data. I tried to create a chart. Let's see. Again,
Yes.
this I don't think this will create a chart. I don't think it is, because for chart you need total counts. This also won't create a chart.
Yes.
Basically you need a total count. If I cure saved, two columns where the counts are there. Yet here, let me wait. I'll give you a report. Whether just hold on. I'll give you Biblio snow item duplicate ISBN location report inventory departmental library. Total collection by item type. I think this will help us. This will help us. Let me check. Added before. Run. Date has been taken. Sorry. It's taken. It's not. Yeah, now I think there will be an chart. And now there is a chart.
Yes.
Now there is a chart.
New option.
And this is a new option. I have not tested yet. So earlier, whatever, we got the charts only. Now it's giving a chart option also. This is
Generation.
You can generate the report again. You can generate the chart from here also. So whenever there will be some inquiry will be coming, you can generate definitely this chart, the report. And in my case, this is helping me a lot. Whenever there is a query comes from any of my IQAC or NAC or NIRF, I am instantly giving the record for your annual report also. The reports are giving instantly. So there is no need of asking my section what are the records. All these things I can give in immediately.
Apurbo.
Yeah.
Just visit the staff client home.
Okay. One mana is some earlier screen. And then.
Now see, I just added two web service reports, and there you see what happens now. Forget the missing icons. Forget the missing icons.
Mm-hmm.
So the first one is your library wise, your branch wise breakup.
Mm-hmm.
It's a branch wise breakup. So using. Yeah, it using the web service, you can consume the output, the JSON output, into this using JavaScript like this.
Okay. Nice. So this comes in my whenever this basically gives a good view.
Yeah.
The first one is not, second one is very much important. Whenever my staff will be seeing the status. Because once the cataloging is done, instantly it will be updated here, isn't it?
Yes.
Instantly it will be updated. So it comes in Koha, in a Seoul, we got some questions. So what will the last record number? So this will help us getting the last record number. Yeah, Sujan is asking something.
Sir, can we share this report on?
Yes, you can.
Okay.
Yes, you can.
You can. This is a public report.
You have to make the report public.
You have to make the report public. So, thank you all. We have already crossed 1 hour earlier.
Yes, I was expecting 30 minutes. Last, I asked you to share some important reports that you daily use in your library. Share some important reports.
Daily, the reports are not mostly used daily, but basically we use reports related to circulation, and mostly we use reports related to circulation for daily. If I go to circulation, checked out during a date range. Like if I go to during a date range, that means how many books are issued till date. I'll give a particular date because the last 2 months no business particular date, February 6th and February 6th again for a particular date. February 6th. I've given the same date because very old date, because after March there were no issues. So this is not giving any output. Let's take another report. Let's take another report from circulation. Mostly we are using circulation reports. Date I checked in books. How many books I have checked in. Between date February 1, weekly, you can say weekly. These are the reports we are basically using more or less daily. These are the date, barcode, and card number. Who are the user? Basically, these are faculty, non-teaching staff, and the students. And this is on the particular day. 1, 2, 6, 7 items has been returned. So these way we generate the reports mostly. Like in a library, most of the libraries do not use any report daily basis, unless it is very much important. Weekly basis, we generate the reports. and for checking. And daily basis, we generate the report when there is a, like when the books are purchased. Because on that time, the daily the books are being added by my catalogers, and I check it mostly the daily if there is, in case of if there is any mistake. So thank you for being with us. I will request all of you to visit our blog as NECOLIB, simply Northeast Collaborative Librarianship, NECOLIB, necolib.blogspot.com. You can have the program details there. Our next program will be on 10th and 11th August on OHA serials control. Then we'll be organizing one training on how to set up a secure network for library automation. The date has not been generated, and different modules we'll be creating, organizing the works. We are not organizing any type of webinar. We are organizing mostly the trainings. Trainings are imparted by all the experts, like IDG SERPs are imparting the COHA training. Sometimes I am sharing, sometimes our other experts, like so networking will be imparted by our network engineer. So we are as the all there is a lockdown, there is nothing to do mostly. We are trying to share the information with us and trying to train our next generation, so that this is the beauty of this open source platform. We are just sharing with each other. Thank you all. I'm signing off now. Sir, thanks for being with us. Yeah.
Thank you, Apurva, sir.
This video yeah. is live, has been live and uploaded, and also this yes. video will be uploaded in our own channel. It has been uploaded in Elias, that is e-learning for all, I think. And again, it will be yes, shared yes. at the same time with NECOLIB, so that it will be going for maximum.
WebEx recording going on, so you can share with school NECOLIB. And Dr. He John Alexander sir also with us. He is active practitioner in he translates in Arabic.
Those are the experts. I am just a simple.
Thank you.
I am not an expert. John is an expert.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
John, sir, say something about this program.
Yeah, good evening to all, and Indranil sir, as well as Apurva Jyoti sir, and everyone. We are trying level best. That's it. You also try.
my simple suggestion: you keep on trying at your end, and whenever there is a problem, we'll share in the forum. We'll try to solve it. And sometimes right. it happens. You have encountered a problem that we have not yet faced, and we'll try to solve it. If the problem is already solved, we'll share the solution. If it is not solved, we'll try to solve it together. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm signing off now.
Bhimal sir also with us. Oh, sir left. Okay. Thank you, sir, for joining with us. And if any feedback from participant, please unmute. Okay, I end this program now. Thank you, sir. Thanks to all for joining.